I know.
So guys, today we're going to be doing another fun pair video, and we're switching up a little bit and actually talking about our first knives, or where it all started for us, how
the
we kind of began.
Knives.
Yep, kind of like the gateway drugs, but the gateway knives to our knife journey. And basically, you guys have seen a lot of our newer knives and how beautiful and awesome and amazing they are. But where did it all start, and how did we begin that kind of quintessential love for bladed objects or things with sharp edges? So that's what I call these two, basically, at this point, things with sharp edges.
They're not so sharp anymore, though. Really.
I'm not sure they actually ever were. It's like, kind of as a kid, you feel like it's really sharp. It's not really.
Not.
You're like, dude, it's like, it's kind of like you have no experience with sharp objects. You're like, whoa, this like partially dull thing.
It can peel the bark off a twig, bro.
I know, it's like, you know, even like a fingernail can do that. Anyways, guys, so without any further ado, please do not forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe to see more awesome content like this. And let's get into this. So, do you want to go first? Or do you want me to go first?
Can we just show both the knives really quick and ask them to guess which one belonged to who?
Yeah, sure. So, let's go for this. You gotta grab one, and if you're gonna show me, you're gonna show them, I already know. Okay, so the first one up is this Maxim knife. You guys probably can't see it because of my mittens, but it's cold, so yes. So this Maxim knife, it's a pretty neat knife, but yeah, you have to take a guess whose knife this was first. And then
next up, we have this no name, nobody, no brand, something or other.
Made in Pakistan, kinda.
This little
pretty cheap, chintzy kind of
piece. And it says Alaska on it.
It says Alaska, that's pretty cool, but it seems like something you'd probably buy.
Well, you'll never guess who this belonged to one point.
Yeah,
you might be surprised.
Yeah, you will, probably. I mean, I think people, when before they get into knives, they really don't know that much about knives, so it's like, it's hard to go off brand names, because it's like, what I really like is, I don't know if any of you guys, probably a lot of you guys are subscribed to Birdshot, XI, I think it is, something like that. But Birdshot, they on their channel, they took two just random kids, they probably were relatives, and they set out a whole bunch of knives ranging from $3.87 to $850. And these kids are putting like $3 knives up in like $200 positions. It's like, whoa. But to a kid or to someone inexperienced, they don't understand the value of knives. So they don't get brand. Like when you say Spyderco, or when you say Kershaw, or when you say Medford Knife and Tool, you know, they don't get those brands like we do. Like when you say Medford, even though I don't like Medford, I still understand it's going to be a very expensive knife, because Medford makes very expensive knives.
And before we reveal which one belongs to, I think we ought to give them a hint.
Okay, what's your hint?
Mine's bigger than yours.
Well, that's a pretty dead giveaway, so yes, of course, she got the Maxim, and I have this thing, and I got this thing years and years and years ago. This
and
little
years
Alaska
and years
knife.
And years ago, yeah.
Yes, I mean, it's been 10 plus, probably like closer to 12 years, and this one, how long ago did you get
that? I think
that?
I was about 5 when I got this, honestly.
And you're 18 now, so that puts
and
you
actually,
like,
I used it. I used
years?
It for a long time. A very long time, actually. I used it up until I was about 10, so I used it for about 5 years.
That's not bad.
But I had, by the time I was 10, I'd already upgraded to better knives, two different forms of multi-tools.
Do you want to bring those out?
I can show them.
I mean, at least one of them.
I'll show the natural evolution of the Ashley knife collection.
Yeah.
So I upgraded to a Wanger Hiker, which, as you can see, is missing the back scales. I don't know when
that
happened.
Fixed.
Honestly, this happened really recently after, like, the big use days of this knife were over. Like, I used this thing for a long time up until I was about... Actually, you know, I think I used this knife up until about...
When you met me.
No. It was about a year or two after I got the Leatherman Blast.
Oh, okay, I get you.
And then I recently found it again, and one of the scales was missing, and I'm like, dang it! And also the toothpick and the tweezers were gone as well, and I'm like, what? No, but these kind of overlap, and I still use both of them. Oh.
Well, not really the Maxim, but the Wanger,
I still use, these overlapped, because I got this and I got this, but I still use both, off and on, quite a bit, until I was about... I think I used this one until I was about 10, and this one until I was about 15.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
I will say, just as a quick note, I really love the Wanger Hiker, and actually, the giveaway for me that it was a Wanger Hiker is because, for some of you guys who know, I actually had one. I actually gave it to my niece because it's a great knife to start out with, especially it's like a great multi-tool. So I actually had a Wanger Hiker. Mine was the black-handled version, but I really love the Wanger Hiker. It is by far, it's no longer made anymore because Fikronox bought them out, but up until that point, the Wanger Hiker was like my go-to Swiss Army knife, but...
And then I upgraded from the Wanger Hiker, which ironically I bought because as a kid I was in love with the TV show MacGyver and I wanted to have the MacGyver knife. So that's how I ended up with this. I upgraded from that to the Blast, and that's just been the natural progression. And these were the three knives that, well, I had a handful of others, but these were the three user knives, mostly these two that I used most of my growing up years up until I met this guy and started upgrading to bigger and better. So. Yeah. That's the natural evolution of the
Archery knife collection. My natural evolution actually is a little bit different. And of course, being the knife nut of us too, because I knew a lot about knives
and
even
I didn't.
Before she did. So, so for me, my natural evolution, I can't really show because I used to have a lot of cheaper knives similar to this one that were, you know, just like mystery Chinese, mystery Taiwanese, mystery Pakistan kind of knives like this one. But the first real knife, I guess what I considered the first real knife, and the first knife that I actually have, I just forgot to bring it out, but is my Benchmade 550. That was my first real knife that I kind of got into. So aside from the Wanger, I guess you could technically consider the Wanger Hiker, I guess, like my next knife. But the first knife that I really consider my knife that I got into was the Benchmade 550. And I've had that one for years and years and years. I just totally forgot to bring it out here so I could show it. But
do we
that was
my next show the
one.
Table?
Well, I don't know. We've kind of shown everything on the table. There's really no mysteries down there. So, yeah.
Anyway.
Anywho, our first knives were really those two, the Maxim and this No Name, and I think they're hilarious knives to look at. And I will say that looking back at these kind of knives, they're what influenced me personally. So like in the beginning of knife, like just the knife world, because I had cheaper like lockbacks like this, for the longest time I actually thought lockback knives were really chintzy and kind of cheap styled knives. But
it's
through
testing. That's funny because I have a frame lock knife here.
No, that's a liner lock.
I mean, that's what I meant, liner lock. But what's funny is that he can open his, I can barely, like, I'm not even gonna try open mine, but mine's sharper than his is.
It's true, but that's because I never really had any good sharpeners.
Mine's got deer on it.
Until now. But anyway, so like with this whole lockback system, I thought that, you know, it was like a really cheap knife, but little did I know, I mean, now we have Spyderco's and Buck 110 and a whole bunch of other lockback.
Oh, I made it. I made
it. Yeah, lockback.
I made it like shift slightly.
Yeah. You need me to get it out?
Squeak. It's squeaking. It's protesting. Okay. Yeah, you try to get
it. Some knives aren't designed to open.
There we go. Reveal yourself.
Anyways.
As you can see, this thing is like really loose and it squeaks and it's horrible. And I was a horrible person to this knife.
Well, that kind of happens as like beginning knives. But anyways, anyways, guys, that was kind of like my kind of influence. And I was like, man, these knives, lockbacks really suck. But now I have like a Buck 110, handful of Spyderco lockbacks, and they're all rock solid, really awesome knives. That's you.
As for me, the only thing I gotta say is this thing is a piece of garbage, but I loved it. Because I didn't know anything about knives back then, but yeah.
Now, what I carry is a little bit different and significantly better. So I'd say a little bit better, but it's way better. ZT0452 carbon fiber. Doesn't even compare. I mean, this thing just flips out. So silky smooth. Lockup is like 20,000 times
the
better than this.
The knife is not even as long as the handle.
This thing is like as small as the actual handle of this knife. It's just an overall way better knife. Made in the US, made out of CPMS 35VN. That thing's out of mystery cheap steel. Anywho, guys, so hopefully you enjoyed this very silly ending. But anyways, guys, those are some of our first knives, and as always, guys, God bless, and
we're out.